Who the fuck dropped ass?
That was me.
I think that's risky, wasn't it?
Hey, shut the fuck up. Concentrate.
I got movement. Second story front window. I'm taking the shot.
Good job. Go, go, go.
Whoa, whoa. Calm it down.
Cover your sides.
Sure.
Clean up aisle three.
Liquid meth, hell yeah!
You one fucked up bitch. All right, who's gonna get this round?
Why they call you Pomo, honey?
Because his ass burns.
The arrest today of a major cartel leader has led to a seizure of hundreds of millions of dollars.
McNeely? Wake up, you drunk fuck.
Oh, my God. I gotta ask you a few questions. $10 million is missing from your cartel bust. Did you steal it?
No. And fuck you for asking.
Two murders of DEA agents have happened on my watch. The cartel thinks you stole the money.
Sweetheart, you're so in over your fucking head. The only way to stop the cartel is to find out who stole the money.
It could be someone on my team, one of my own people.
Get out of the fucking car! It's you, or it's Grindr, or Sugar, or my dear loving husband.
You're fucking crazy.
You see any other feds getting smoked?
Cartel's got your wife and kid. I'm sorry.
Tell John to come for you.
Please don't fight me!
I'm gonna destroy them. Just say I'm a kid.
Sabotage is an action crime drama thriller movie that was released on March 28, 2014. This is one of Arnold Schwarzenegger's more modern movies, but do I enjoy it or not? Well, let's find out by starting, as always, with the story. The story follows a DEA task force who raid a drug cartel safe house, but then afterwards, members of the force get killed one by one. One member, Breacher, tries to figure out who it is, and is open to the possibility that it could be one of his own team members. I think the story is really fucking good. First of all, the story is actually darker than most Arnold Schwarzenegger movies. But the dark material is used exclusively to create intrigue, and is integral to the story. The members of the DEA team are very fucking cool people. These are people I would absolutely love to hang around with and talk to. They even have strippers as an award for a successful mission, and hell yeah, I'm down with that. So it makes it all more tragic when they start getting killed randomly. You really feel the pain that Breacher feels when this starts happening. The team is all he has left, and now that is being taken away from him. Which makes it all the more painful. Some may not like the fact that the characters cuss a bunch, but I don't mind that. Because they are often dealing with the scum of the goddamn earth, so it is pretty appropriate. There are even some strong female characters, but they're actually fucking fun to watch. Well, one of them starts out that way, but then turns into a cunt later on. But the other is a ballsy woman, which is very nice. Though she's not the best character of all time, she's still pretty good. I will say a lot of people don't like the ending of the movie, but I have to say, I thought it was really fucking good. To the point where I thought that they could not have ended it better than they did. I've been getting into spoiler territory recently, so I will just say this. I thought it was genuinely satisfying and did not have to add anything else. It kind of says to enjoy your pleasures in life until it all ends. Breacher was a character that I ended up rooting for, and I think he's a good guy. He at least tries to be a good person, which automatically makes him better than the bad guys. Those who thought he was not a good guy probably think it's so easy to be good. Newsflash, it's not. Like, at all. But those who actually try are ones who deserve respect. This movie does actually reflect reality to an extent, and still manages to have clear good guys and bad guys, as well as a few minor characters in the gray area. You know, like how a lot of movies do. The action scenes are pretty goddamn satisfying. There are plenty of guns and blood, but they do add in an explosion or two to mix things up a bit. I don't remember there being a fight scene, but not every movie has to have a fight. I don't remember there being a fight scene, but not every action movie has to have a fight scene. As long as the rest of the action is filmed and edited well, you're fine. And this movie definitely has that. The production values are pretty good. The cinematography, editing, sound, and sets are all well done, and all add to the movie's modern-day rugged style. The music is pretty forgettable, however. I don't really remember the score or any song that was used. In fact, the music in the trailer is more memorable than the music in the actual movie. But overall, Sabotage is a pretty fucking good modern Schwarzenegger movie. It actually has a good dark story, awesome action scenes, and decent production values, minus the music. And overall has a sense of finality to it. Much more, in fact, than the previous modern Schwarzenegger movie, ironically titled The Last Stand. But for Sabotage, it almost feels like the filmmakers thought this would be his last movie. While it wasn't, I can't help but really enjoy watching the movie and having a completely different feeling toward the end compared to the beginning. You know what? I think I'm going to give Sabotage 5 out of 5 stars with the title of Epic. Anyway, I'm Spike Robot. Thank you all for watching, and see you next time.